Welcome back everyone, and today let's create a really shiny card. I have here the latest glimmer kit of the month. This is a hot foiling kit by Spellbinders, and you get a wreath this time along with a couple of dies that helps you cut out the wreath on the outside or on the inside or both, depends how you want to use it. You will also get a couple of sentiments with matching dies and a little die that cuts out lots of tiny flowers. So first let's do the foiling. And I plan to work on this dark green cardstock. It makes every card look more dramatic and it helps the focal points pop even more. And I'm going to do the foiling with gold foil. So I placed all the foiling plates on my machine. I did place the foil on top and then the green cardstock. I'm adding my two shims and I don't need an extra one I have found with my machine. And once they are ready and warm, I'm going to run them through a couple of times through my die cutting machine. At this stage, I didn't know with which sentiment I'm going to go for my final card, so I went ahead and foiled both of them that were included. In any case, I can have an extra one for another card later on. And it's time to do my die cutting. I'm going to cut out the wreath outside and inside as well as the two sentiments. And I absolutely love how the gold foiling looks on a really dark cardstock. So as I'm going to run through the machine the two sentiments, I will also die cut a few of those tiny flowers using red cardstock so that I can later on embellish my wreath. Now, if you look at the wreath really closely, you will be able to see that shape. So I think that this is the correct way to place it. So I'm going to temporarily place it on top of my card base and then I will use the die that cuts out the inside of the wreath. I use the washi tape to keep everything together and I'm going to run it through my die cutting machine. This way I will create a window on the green panel that will match perfectly with the wreath in the exact position that I want that window to go. And I'm going for a shaker cut, that's why I'm just using the wreath to measure about how much of that acetate I'm going to need. I'm going to stick it at the back. In any case, if you don't like working with shaker cards, you can definitely recreate this without the shaker element. You can just add the sentiment on the inside of the wreath just for an extra layer. And my shaker window is ready. I'm also going to go around that window at the back with some foam tape. But before I do that, while this panel is completely flat still, I'm going to add some inking on the outside edges of this panel. For that, I'm working with Distress Ink, and that's Black Soot. If you ink up the edges of a really dark cardstock like I'm doing here, it is going to help the look and feel of the card to look more dramatic and the focal points are going to pop even more. Now, I'm doing my inking on top of a silicone mat. This is by Waffle Flower and I get a lot of questions about that. I'm using that just because it is easier for me to see where I have ink. Sometimes just because my glass mat is black, I don't see where there is ink and I don't clean it that well. And I may transfer ink and do smudges on my project without knowing. And I'm going to use my foam strips at the back to create a little pocket so that I can add the shaker elements inside and they are not going to fly away. The foam strips that I'm using are again by Waffle Flower, really handy to use, and they actually come in two thicknesses, so you can choose whichever you like depending on how much dimension you want to add on your projects. Now I have a scrap piece of paper from a pattern paper that I had from ages ago. I believe this is from an old Tim Holtz collection and I want to give a vintage look and feel, but you can use gold cardstock at the back or even any Christmas pattern paper. And now back at the front, I do have some foam tape at the back of my wreath. I'm going to place it around the window. It gives some dimension and a beautiful finish on the window. And now all we have to do is to add a sentiment and decorate the wreath. For that, I'm going to use the tiny flowers that I cut out using the die from this kit, but I'm also going to bring in a few poinsettia flowers that are from my Christmas birdhouse collection. In my birdhouse die set, you will also find this die that cuts out a bow, which I'm going to put together using gold cardstock. So here I'm just inking up the flowers only lightly at the edges to give them a more vintage look and feel. And you can see here where I cannot really tell if I have ink on my glass mat. That's why I tend to use that white silicone mat. Anyway, I forgot here, so I may make a mess later on. I am putting the flower together, one on top of the other, and offsetting the petals. And for the center, I'm going to use one of the little golden elements that are in the same shaker mix that I used for the window. I also did put together the bow, and it's finally time to place everything on top of my card and finish it off. So the bow is going to go at the bottom. I'm also going to add the poinsettia at the top, as well as stick a few of those tiny red flowers along the wreath. If you are enjoying my videos, don't forget to like as well as leave me a comment down below. These are just a few ways to support my channel and help me share even more ideas. So that was the project for today. I hope that you had fun, that you got inspired. Just like always, down below in the description area, you will find links to everything I used. Thank you all so much for joining me today, and I'll see you all next time.